December 29th, my friend and coworker Kyle and I made the nearly 6.5 hour journey from central Kentucky to southwest Virginia to embark on a winter backpacking trip for the ages. Our destination was the Grayson Highlands, and our setting was an Arctic tundra of snow, clouds, and frigid temperatures. Grayson Highlands is an alpine Eden. The lofty landscape is embellished by airy mountain meadows, gushing trout streams, rhododendron-filled forest, and a conglomeration of high peaks. The extensive 4,800-acre state park provides any nature enthusiast with premier wildlife watching potential within the mountain range that is home to Virginia's highest peak, Mount Rogers. Habitats within the park range from open meadows and northern hardwoods to sphagnum bogs and Fraser fir groves. The forests here contain a number of mountain meadows or balds. These meadows provide excellent views of the surrounding area and present a striking change in scenery from the surrounding forests. The balds are dominated by large rocky outcroppings, clear of vegetation, except for the occasional windswept tree and low grasses. The most popular trails are over 4,000 feet in elevation, and weather can be 15 to 20 degrees cooler and wind speeds twice as high as the bottom of the mountain. One of the park's highlights is the band of more than 100 ponies roaming the highlands, including a famous flaxen-maned stallion named Fabio, renowned for his salon-quality locks. The origin of the equines is somewhat mysterious, but one story suggests the ponies were bred by locals to survive the fickle Appalachian high country with minimal human interference. Inside the park, the herd was introduced by the Forest Service in 1974 to provide a natural landscaping service for the Highland balds, which was first cleared by loggers at the end of the 19th century and later grazed by cattle throughout the first half of the 20th century.
Thank you.
After our summit of Mount Rogers, we found a campsite before 3 p.m. where we would spend the next 15 hours inside our tents to find relief from the assault of wind and spindrift snow blowing across this lofty ridge.
Hold mine like hamburger and hot dog, and then until I get like a long column, and then I'll roll it. If you want to,
you're welcome. When we finally crawled out of our tent Sunday morning, the wintry veil enveloping us the day prior had finally dissipated, leaving us with bluebird skies and slightly warmer temperatures for the remainder of the day. By the time we reached the crest trail, the vistas had opened up to reveal a crystalline nirvana.
Tuck all those insides in it.
Yeah, I try to just be able to see the dark gray, not the green.
Pretty sure my tent weighs an extra pound from ice.
All right, ready to rock.
Yep.
Get your big hunk.
Thank you, sir. Here's you some more.
Thank you, sir. You want any more figgy newtons or fruit? Fruit foods or?
See how I feel after.
Jack links or?
We decided to make the wise shelter our abode for our final night on trail, which came as a relief to us when thinking about potentially pitching our frozen tents from the night before. It was a perfect spot to relax inside our downed cocoons as the sun set over the tree line with warm food and conversation about our lives, childhoods, and families.
Stronger than thick.
It doesn't taste bad. But the little amount I put in there earlier tastes like normal coffee. Mm. And this tastes past that.
Interesting. I wonder if you put more in there than I did.
It's got stuff. It's got
the juice in it.
The good stuff. Oh, yeah.
That's who your uncle did.
He used to be in high school.
That was the most scary moment of my life,
for sure. Your headlight's still on. I don't know if that was intentional or not.
Still lit up?
Yeah. At least we're consistent.
Yeah, we are consistent.
Ready to do the final stretch? Let's go.
We brought in the new year Monday morning with the final 3 miles of trail, where the ponies came to send us off the mountain in true Highland style. We arrived back at Kyle's car feeling grateful for the experience, and thankful to be back in the comforts of the developed world.
And I found one of your dryer balls. I just carried it up the top of a mountain. Oh, it's wet now.
I like this tent more so than the last tent. Whatever origami boy had me do it. I can't. Okay, I can't.
Yes, you can.
You could have put this sign on the other end. Gosh. Friggin' idiots!
Oh, blooper.
One more hot dog, or?
Yeah, one more hot dog.
I like hot dogs.
Are we sure this is the trail?
Kyle's like, I'm not about that.
Well, I mean, looks like I'd be, I'm about to be. I wonder if
there might be a little bit better.
You're right.
You got to, I will.
We're not crossing that way, I guess, according to Kyle.
Boy, you quadzilla.
Chad and Nick, are they crazy glove people? Are they hardcore?
No, they're smart. Get kicked.
Like Sarah, I always tell her she has to be the last one ready no matter what. Like, she can be completely ready, but it's like, gotta wait until I'm completely ready to do the last
thing.
Shit. I'm like, you do that intentionally. She does not appreciate my commentary.
Blooper.
Oh, hello. Hi there. Do you think I was calling for you? Do you think I was calling for you? You're very cute. You're a cutie. Thanks for letting me get to pet you. You're a good girl. You're a good girl. Okay, I'm gonna go now. Bye-bye. No, you don't want me to go. Bye-bye. And that's a wrap.